Welcome to Real Bass Lessons. Today I'm going to teach you some stuff about soloing. A little bit with a jazz flavor, but it applies to all kinds of soloing. I've been teaching improvisation, soloing, for many years, and I've actually been working on a book for a lot of years called Improvising with Rhythm and Melody. Well, this is part of it. This is specifically working on shapes for soloing. And the subtitle is in the upper register. We're going to play up in here. This sounds quite different playing here than it does here with certain notes. Okay? So here we go. We're going to use that jazz tune called Lady Bird. It's not a real complicated one. I recommend you know it, learn it. If you don't know it right now, stop it, learn it a little bit so it'll make sense. Okay? I'm going to play it a little bit for you, and then we'll get into it, just so you can hear the sound. 2, 3, 4. Some play along in a little while so you can work with that. But now what I'm talking about is shapes, and I mean little small 2 and 3 note shapes. You might call them triads. That's a 3 note chord, but I'm thinking of a more of a shape because they all aren't necessarily triads, but they sort of hint in this little area called upper structure triads. So they're not, for example, on C major. We're not playing a C major. We're thinking of this. That's an E minor triad. And of course, that sounds cool over a C major because these notes are part of that chord. Next chord is F minor 7 to B flat 7. Look. That's an E flat major triad. Then back to C major. The next one I play up here is major triad. Then it goes to B flat minor, E flat 7 to A flat 7. And here I play a D flat major triad, resolving to a little C minor triad for that A flat major. Then A minor, C major triad to D7. Then that D minor G7 sound. And that there's a little diminished triad, isn't it? And then C major. Cool, let's listen to it. I'll put the little play along behind it. A 1, 2, 3, 4. You can follow that. Let me talk and explain it real again. By the way, back up. To start with, I'm not doing this because theoretically I figured this out. I'm doing it because these little melodic shapes lead right into each other. It's a voice leading. And of course, one can analyze it theoretically, but I choose not to. I just let my ear guide me. Again, listen to this. Yeah. So what we're talking about here is playing a line, looking for a line, learning how to figure out a little 2- and 3-note chord. And again, play them in arpeggiated style, a little melodic shape that will fit through the chord changes, not necessarily with them. See, if we were to think roots, we'd be going C major, F minor, B flat 7, C major, B flat minor, E flat 7, A flat 7. And there's nothing wrong with that. Some of you may need to do that in the beginning because you don't know the chords. But then we want to start working on a line that just sort of flows through them. So again, I'm going to play it in time here with a little drum machine. And I'll put the rhythm section behind it. I'll play the same stuff I played earlier. C, E minor triad. A 1, 2, a 1, 2, 3, 4. E flat major. D major. D flat major. C minor. C major. And this little diminished sound. D minor. G7. C major. E flat. A flat. D. Now, did you see on that last little turnaround? I played every one of those chords from the root. Well, I would not normally do that. I'd do something like this. See, that all fits over this. That fits this, and then this. And then I went, Sure. I'm looking for these little guide tone shape movements in there. Good. Now I'm going to do the same thing, but I'm going to improvise around with it, which means I'll play those exact shapes. I'll just put notes in between it. And by the way, what are notes in between it? Well, they're the ones that just fit that tonality at the moment. Let's do that. Two, a 1, 2, 3. Simple this is to play. Physically, it's easy to play. Maybe your ear isn't hearing it right now, but that's why I made this lesson. Just copy the sounds and play along with them. You'll get used to it. I'm sure at the moment right now when you hear that little D major triad, it sounds kind of strange against that C. And yeah, you can go analyze it, the 9, the 13, the sharp 11. No, don't do that. Just learn to hear these little sounds. And when you get some of these little sounds, you've done them so much that they're in your ear, you'll start to use them in all other places. I'm teaching a student now who's quite advanced, an adult player who's been a professional for many years, but he's almost always played the bass, you know, rightly so, from the root. We're now starting to work on some of these little melodic shapes, and it's just setting him free. So be patient with yourself on this, but do it over and over and over. I'm going to do it one more time, okay? I'll just illustrate it. Two, a 1, 2, 3, 4. Yeah, Yeah, I made one little mistake in there, but I think you heard it and I cleaned it up. Cool. Get into this, okay? I am going to publish the book. I'm thinking I'll start with a sort of a smaller version of that improvising rhythm melody. I'll just do one on this called Shapes for Soloing in the Upper Register of the Bass. I'm having fun with this stuff. I've been teaching it for years, and now I'm codifying it, getting it all all together and hopefully clear to illustrate. Right on. Hope you enjoyed it.